You might have heard that 2 weeks ago, a state of emergency was allegedly declared at Italy's Campi Flegrei Volcano in response to a magnitude 4.4 earthquake which struck. Since approximately 340,000 people live within this giant complex of calderas, cones, and craters, and the fact that it is so close to the 900,000 people within the city of Naples, this should be quite concerning, right? Only one problem. This didn't actually happen, despite widespread reports to the country in various news publications. Yet, there was sort of an attempt to declare a state of emergency. Confused? Let me explain. In Italy, the government agency dedicated to protecting citizens and property from natural disasters is called Protezione Civile. For a state of emergency to be officially declared, the process shown on screen must be carried out. 2 weeks ago, the head of Protezione Civile requested an investigation by his own agency to determine if there truly is a need to declare a state of emergency at the Campi Flegrei volcano due to its current unrest. After what I interpret was some behind-the-scenes discussions from relevant experts, the minister changed his stance and decided there was no need for an actual state of emergency declaration. However, I want to remind everyone that I am largely unfamiliar with the structure and nature of Italian politics, so the diagram I made along with my interpretations involving the actions or lack thereof for specific people and organizations is potentially quite wrong, but I made it to the best of what in my opinion seems to have occurred. The last and only true time there was actually a state of emergency declared at the Campi Flegrei volcano was during an episode of rapid intense uplift totaling up to 1.85 meters or 72.8 inches between 1982 to 1985, which led to the evacuation of 40,000 people. For comparison, as of today, the current maximum rate of uplift at Campi Flegrei is only 18 centimeters a year. This uplift isn't truly new, as it has been ongoing for some time, with Campi Flegrei having been maintained at a raised alert level of yellow for 13 years and counting now, dating all the way back to 2012. This now more than decade-long episode of unrest is caused by magma intruding into a laccolith-like sill at 3 kilometers depth, uplifting the overlying ground. Yet, for all intents and purposes, we aren't seeing any warning signs that a volcanic eruption will occur relatively soon. Instead, just like 3 far more intense episodes of uplift which occurred during the latter half of the 20th century, the potential danger that does exist to some locals is not related to a volcanic eruption, but rather the ground uplift and/or subsidence associated with the overall volcano. This process has caused specific patches of ground within its largest caldera to rise and fall by allegedly as much as 25 meters or 82 feet during portions of the last few thousand years due to a process known as bradyseism. The main problem with this ground deformation is that during greatly heightened episodes of ground uplift, the ground both rises at an uneven amount which most structures are not built to withstand, and that much of this motion is episodically released via light magnitude 4 range earthquakes associated with earthquake swarms. While ordinarily, magnitude 4 range earthquakes would not be sufficient to harm literally any person or structures, a number of local factors legitimately allow these earthquakes to sometimes cause damage and potentially harm people. One such example within the caldera occurred on March 23rd of this year when two smaller quakes of magnitude 4.0 and 3.3 struck at the same time, causing some damage to various structures and injuring 11 people, with some rubble falling onto various streets. Now, I want to note that much of the photos of scattered damage I am showing at some structures in today's video could have very well already looked like this for many years before Campi Flegrei's latest unrest began, but a local who lives nearby thought that the damage he photographed was mostly new having occurred in the last few years due to Campi Flegrei's uplift and earthquakes. Most of this damage is consistent with occasional MMI-6 shaking. These potentially damaging earthquakes are far more likely to occur during heightened episodes of ground deformation since the deformation at Campi Flegrei has widely varied in the past few years. Lasting anywhere from a few days to multiple months in duration, its rate of uplift since 2020 has varied from actual very negligible subsidence to 91.3 centimeters a year of uplift. However, the latter figure occurred for less than a week. The earthquake storms tend to occur in closely spaced clusters that span a few months, only to be followed by a longer period of lesser activity. In my opinion, I would only expect a potential for another state of emergency to be declared if sustained uplift without pause is 50 centimeters or greater for at least an entire year, with the main risk being earthquake damage to structures and not a likelihood of a volcanic eruption. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Squish, for supporting this channel.